Hi, it's Wesley with 22 Zines. Welcome to Day 7 of International Zine Month. The official prompt for today is, what's a zine distro? Educate yourself of what zine distros are, how they operate, and how they pick zines to carry. Support a distro near you. So, let's talk about it. A zine distro, distro is short for distributor, and so that means any store or any group that distributes zines is a zine distro. And usually a zine distro is one that distributes zines from multiple different authors, so it's either a collective of some sort, or it's a store where they sell on consignment, or they purchase zines at wholesale prices and then resell them. And that's basically what a distributor is. The methods for zine distros selecting different zines varies a lot. Like I said, some of them will buy on consignment, and so they will basically just pick it up and then offer you a percentage of the sale, like a percentage of the profit once it actually sells. Some of them, when they are buying wholesale, will go out and buy a certain amount of stock of the zine, usually at about like 40 to 60% of cover price. I actually haven't seen a 40. It's really more like 50% is pretty much the standard. And so, you know, if you're selling your zine at $2, then they'll buy it for you at $1 each, and they'll buy in bulk. Probably like for the first time, they'll buy like 5 to 10, maybe, unless they think that it's going to do really, really well. When I sold my zine, Death, the first copy of my tarot zine, to, Julia at Crap Pandemic, it sold out really quick, and so they bought another, like, 15 or 20 copies immediately after that. So, it all just kind of depends. So, how they choose what to carry, like, some distros will have rather specific, niches that they're trying to fill. Some of them, if they are looking to flesh out their collection of one particular type of zine, like they want more social justice zines or they want whatever, then they will be specifically seeking those. Most zine distributors that I've seen, they will get submissions. And so you will submit your zine to be sold at a distro. I don't think that very many zine distributors will specifically go out and contact zine creators to see if they can stock their zine in their shop, unless it's something like completely mind-blowing that they really, really want in the shop. But really, I don't think that that's the typical process or the typical practice. It's mostly that they will be receiving submissions. Some of them will receive submissions year-round. Some of them have specific you know, times that they will advertise that they are looking for submissions. That's usually more for larger distros that are really famous that, you know, just can't handle the demand of submissions. But just in general, a recap, the vast majority of zine distros will be receiving zines on submission or on consignment. If it's on submission, then they will be getting it probably year round, unless it's a special case and you just contact them and you say, hey, I think my zine would be a good fit for your distro. I'd really like to sell it with you. And you'll usually send a preview copy, for them to read, that, you know, like a free preview copy, to see if they would want to stock the zine in their distro. If it does fit, and it's really not a very strict process, I think, for accepting a zine or not. Usually, I think the biggest factor that influences most zine distributors is the price of it. So if they're not going to stock your zine, 9 times out of 10, it's probably because they just don't think that they'd be able to sell it for the price that you're asking. You know, and that's just how it goes. But, you know, if it's a reasonable price, it's probably going to fit in there, unless it's like a very specific niche kind of distro and it just doesn't really fit with the category. But you know, in general, I feel like most distros are pretty broad on their categories, even the specific ones. Like, Juliet Crap Pandemic advertises Crap Pandemic as being the world's only goth zine distro. But what counts as goth is very broad. But what counts as goth is very broad. And, so it's really just, if you like it, if you like the distro, and you feel like, yeah, you know, my zine would fit in here, then it probably will, and it will probably get accepted if they are accepting submissions, and if it's at a price that they can manage. So, little disclaimer, I am not a zine distributor, and I do not buy zines for that sake. I am a zine librarian, so I do collect and make decisions on purchasing zines for a zine library, but that is a slightly different thing, and especially because my zine library is a public library, and so that's also sort of a different thing. So I don't mean to speak for all zine distributors or anything, but just in my experience as a zine creator who has sold to zine distributors, this is my understanding of what a zine distro is, how they make their decisions, and just what they do. The benefits of selling to a zine distro, you might think, like, why should I sell to a zine distro if they're only going to give me 50%? And the benefits are that, you know, they have a much wider audience. It's a lot easier for people to find zine distros than it is to find you specifically. You don't have to deal with shit like seller fees. You don't have to mail it a bunch of different places yourself. It's just pretty cut and dry. Like, you send it to them, and then they deal with all that stuff. There's usually a much larger reach because a lot more people will follow a specific distro if they like the stuff that the distro produces. And so that's a benefit. Plus, just the fact that you are supporting a zine distributor, which usually zine distributors will do a lot for the zine community, especially in their area. They, not all zine distributors have a physical location, but those that do, it's really special because they are providing a space where people can come and browse for zines and come and discover more zines. So, you know, a lot of them will do workshops and will attend events. And so it's, you know, in addition to taking a lot of stress off you and getting a wider reach, selling to a zine distributor will just help support the zine community at large. So I now have a short list of a few zine distros that I personally really like, and I'm just gonna run them off relatively quickly. You should definitely check out if there are zine distros in your area. You can just Google, like, zine distro your location, or, you know, if there are any nearby, especially within your country, because I know these are all going to be US-based, just because I usually buy from US-based, because that's where the shipping costs are going to be cheapest. Sorry about any street noise from the background. That's what happens when you live in a city. But there are, I know that there are a lot of zine distros in the UK. I know of a few in Australia. I know of a few in Germany. I know of a few in Belgium. And I'm sure, and I know of a few in India. There's a few, like, there's zine distros wherever you are. So just don't worry about sticking to these American distros. But if you happen to want to purchase from an American distro, then here is a short list of a whole bunch of great ones. Crap Pandemic, as I've mentioned many times before, and I will continue to mention many times, is an excellent zine distro. I sell some of my zines through that distro, and Julia, who runs it, advertises it as the world's only goth zine distro. They are based in Indiana and have a really excellent selection. I am hard-pressed to find a zine that I don't like and that I don't want to have in that, in the distro, so, you know, highly recommend it. Crap Pandemic's really great. Mend My Dress Press is a really nice little distro. They don't have a super wide selection, but they do have a lot of compilation zines, so, like, people who have put out dozens of issues of a particular zine, they'll compile them all into a thicker book style zine, and Mend My Dress Press has a whole bunch of those, which is really great. They are based in Washington. They're just a really awesome little distro that has longer stuff, so I highly recommend Mend My Dress Press. Neither Nor Zine Distro has a really big selection. They're based in Kansas, and What I really like about Neither Nor is that it's super easy to browse and it's super fun to browse because they have some really great categories for browsing. They have a whole category for zines made by POC. They have a category for zines made by queer people, or like feminism and queer zines, I think is the whole category. They have one for zines on mental health. So there are a lot of really nicely tailored categories that fit very well with International Zine Month prompts. Hint, hint, if you're still looking to complete some of those. So Neither Nor Zine Distro is a really great one. I've ordered from them before. I've got a patch from them on my vest. So really great. Highly recommend. Microcosm Publishing in Oregon has been around for kind of a long time. I think since like 2000 or something like that. And what's really nice about them is they have a lot of books and zines that they publish themselves. They're a small publisher, and they also do consignment zine, or not consignment, sorry. They also purchase zines to sell. And so they have a lot of really great ones. They have a lot of punk stuff. They have a lot of vegan stuff. They have a lot of really practical DIY guides. That's really handy. Like, they focus a lot on DIY and skill building. So they have a lot of really great stuff on that. They have stuff on finance. They have stuff on parenting. And they also have a really nice tagging system. It's not as clear in the sense of, you know, it's not like they have certain categories that they put everything into. I mean, they do have categories, but it's not exactly the same. But they do have tags for subject. So if you click on the zines page, and then it should have right above there like a big link tree of a bunch of different categories. And so it will be, you know, keywords like art, per zine, DIY, and they'll be really specific too. It'll say like witchcraft, finance, parenting, vegan. It'll have like a whole bunch of tags there. So if you're looking for like a specific zine or a zine about a specific subject, that's really, really convenient. So I really like Microcosm, highly recommend them. Again, Microcosm Publishing, based in Oregon. Portland Buttonworks is the zine distro that is run by Alek, who put on International Zine Month, and it has also been around for a while. It's really great. There's a huge selection of books and zines, and the Buttonworks is because they also do custom button orders, which is really cool. And they also have, this is a relatively recent thing, they have a specialty shop for paganism, witchcraft, tarot, and just generally like witchy stuff. And so that's where they put all of their witchy zines and books that fit into that category. I bought the Moon book by Sarah Faith Gottesdiener. I'm just reading it off my shelf right now. And I sell my tarot zines with Alek through the witch shop. And so it's really fun. It's a really greatly tailored little category among Portland Buttonworks. So highly recommend checking that one out. I forgot to mention that a lot of zine distro owners will, if you are selling with them, they often will also offer trades. So if you are interested in some or any zines from their catalog, then they will do trades for your zines, which is really cool. I know that Alek offers store credit at Portland Buttonworks, and I have absolutely taken advantage of that. So that's also really cool if you are, you know, interested in both getting your zine out there and reading other people's zines. Stay Kind Zine Distro is a really cute little zine distro that is actually super local to me. Like, literally, we use the same post office, and Dawn Graham, who runs it, like, she basically left me a note when I ordered from them that said, like, I was thinking of just coming by and dropping this in your mailbox rather than sending it out through the mail, but I thought that might be weird. By the way, Dawn, if you ever happen to be watching this, please feel free to drop by anytime. So, Stay Kind Zine Distro. Basically, it's a little distro. They sell on consignment, and they have really super cheap zines, a whole lot of them on sex education. If that's, I mean, they have other zines too, but if you happen to be especially interested in that. They have a really wide selection on that. And what's really cool is that Dawn donates like 20%, I think, of her profits to charitable causes, which is really cool. I forgot the official name. I think it's Families for Justice is what it is right now that she's donating to. And that is a charity for Black and Brown women who are formerly incarcerated. And so it's just, it's really cool. And it's local to me, which I love. And you also get to support charitable causes with your zine purchase. So it's a win-win. And finally, I have Wasted Ink Zine Distro, which is a very large and pretty long-standing zine distro in Arizona. And this is an absolutely huge selection, probably the biggest catalog out of any of the ones that I've listed, maybe, except for maybe Portland Buttonworks, except that Wasted Ink is pretty much all zines instead of books. So anyway, absolutely huge selection. Any sort of zine that you're trying to find, you will probably find it there. And they're all super nice down there. They do have a physical location, and they do a whole lot of events, and they support the local art scene in Tucson, I think they're based in Arizona. And it's just really cool. And they also have a Patreon where you can sign up for a monthly donation, and they will mail out a special surprise pack of zines to you every month, which I completely love. I'm signed up to two of those right now, or I guess technically I have three subscriptions right now to various zine distros, monthly zines, and this is one of them. Always really high quality and really nice, and they include a whole bunch of extra bonuses like patches and buttons and stickers and things in them. So I highly recommend that if you are interested in getting into zines but you don't really know what you're looking for, or you're just a little overwhelmed, then that can kind of be a nice way to both get a surprise in your mailbox and sort of get your feet wet with zines. That's really nice. And for today only, I'm sorry that I'm uploading this video late because it means that you have less time to use this code, but for today only, Wasted Ink Zine Distro, as part of a celebration for International Zine Month and for Distro Day, is offering 10% off with the coupon code ILOVEZINES, all lowercase, just all one word, ILOVEZINES, for 10% off of your order from Wasted Ink Zine Distro today, July 7th, 2021 only. So if you happen to see this before then, I highly recommend that you check them out and use the code. So that's all I got on Zine Distros for now. Of course, if you have any questions on Zine Distros, I can probably help you out with that. And other than that, I will see you tomorrow for a very exciting and unusual zine month prompt. Bye.